So we finna get up out of this job and another out. This is America, and I'm Irish though.
He said what?
Oh, this is America, but I'm Irish.
You Irish?
Yeah.
How, you nigga, you from South Memphis. How the fuck you Irish, nigga?
Memphis is most known for its music, if you ask me. It's soul, it's barbecue, it's crime. We just gonna be real about it. It's a hard place to come up.
The Soulsville is one of the poorest zip codes in the city. Grade 126 is the poorest zip code in the country, which is right up the street. Grade 106 is a close behind.
My grandma adopted me when I was 2, and she moved me to Salt Lake City, Utah. And I lived out there for 10 years until I moved back when I was 12.
I have a lot of memories of coming here with my grandma and getting Cracker Jacks and liver cheese and a sleeve of crackers, you know what I'm saying? Some hot sauce, you feel me? Yeah. You can still see where the deli was, you know what I'm saying?
One of my earliest memories of moving back home was going to the local grocery store, walking in the door, and my grandma turned around, I was like, boy, what you doing, come on. And I was standing there, just looking around, because I was in awe, because I had never seen so many black people in one place at one time. I'm guessing people get that feeling when they walk into Memphis Rox, because it's like, when it comes to climbing, you might not never seen so many black people in one place at one time.
Now, as you climb on the wall, just starting off, try to look for ones like this orange one, or this green right here behind you. They're gonna be the beginner level ones. And after that, once you go through the cave, you'll see all the V's, everything that's actually scaled to let you know if it's easy or hard. Hope y'all enjoy your time now, sir. Oh, yeah. Shoes is like a presidential job at Memphis Rox.
You say it's like the presidential job?
Yes, indeed, it's like a presidential job at Memphis Rox. And I'll tell you, I got my own little no-no square.
The socially distant square?
What you said, 6 feet, then I can go all the way up to 12, because I got a broom that extends my length. I'm in here.
Get your ass back.
Then I got my own two cans of spray, Misty 2 and Misty 1. What you said, I'm here. No-no square locked down.
That's not bad.
Not bad. No-no, don't touch me there. This is my no-no square.
So how do you find out about Memphis Rox? Just being in the neighborhood?
I ain't go for it. The main person telling me about Memphis Rox, I asked him, what is it? What's going on here? He's like, it's one family Memphis Rox, rock climbing the gym. Like, huh? What is it? Rock climbing. What is rock climbing?
Like you didn't do, did you ever have a chance to go to like summer camp or anything like that?
No.
That's where I first experienced it.
Everybody has a story to tell. We've all overcome something. I believe preserving a moment is almost more important than a perfect picture, especially in the field of journalism.
It's like a whole bunch of front pages. I tried to keep it.
I have been documenting protests since I was a photojournalist in 2017. I started at the New Tri-State Defender, which is the oldest black newspaper in the city.
The Take 'Em Down 901 protests with the Bedford Forest statue being removed were stories that kind of propelled my career. And those two were before I started working at Memphis Rox.
When the protests came this year, I was still scared. It was an intensity that I've never felt before.
The police line was up here, came across the parking lot. And they came all the way down and set up a blockade.
Driving the wrong way on one-way streets, running red lights. You'd hear an explosion over here, gunshots over here, police galloping down the street on horses. There's beauty in anarchy because it's just like the system needs to know that like you can't treat people like this. Memphis Rox is a place of hope. When you're on a wall, it's your chance to escape what's going on. It's a safe haven. Your bank account doesn't matter. When it's a wall in front of us, we usually have a common goal. Are we working on the same route? Do you know the beta?
Wait, don't do that yet. Switch your foot.
And you get to break down stereotypes through interaction.
After you switch feet, now you went out left, then switch feet, and then moved over. And still, you're able to not cross, so that was cool.
What made you like climbing when you first started doing it?
I guess because this is the good spot I'm good in.
That's what you're good at.
I used to have friends playing outside with. I ain't like them no more. I ain't want to play with them.
They would try to pick on you?
Yeah.
Does being up here make you feel safe?
Yeah, it make me feel normal and happy.
It make you feel normal and happy?
Yeah,
you're going to have some new shots for your Instagram, though. So you can get your likes up.
So what are you gonna do first? Can you divide this before getting rid of that?
No.
Nope. So what are you gonna do?
You gotta divide and subtract.
I don't even know if I can solve some of this.
You wanna walk him through a problem?
How did the gym like help you and Aiden?
Like, I know Aiden needs a lot of attention.
He came a lot more social. He talked more. He showed his feelings more, you know. Mm. Now I guess that's the same for me too. Here I can like actually express myself, you know.
There you go. And then set your feet so we can get a good shot of you. Get your other hand on that white. There you go.
Do I know who's coming tomorrow?
Yeah. I like it.
He coming.
I know you're excited. You don't look excited, but you're excited.
What? Kyle Lightner coming here tomorrow?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know Kyle was coming.
I know. He just told me to surprise you.
Now I'm happy.
When it comes to role models and rock climbing, like, representation is important.
Hey, how you doing?
Good.
When Kai first came to the gym and we had young kids there, it's like, I ain't never seen someone do that before. And I'm glad the first time you saw someone do it was a black dude. That sets a different type of precedent.
When you actually pressure your foot, you want to keep the ball of your foot, like this part, near here, so like this. I definitely think that since last time I climbed, your feet used to skid all over the place, but now like they look very purposeful when you place them on the wall. Nice. You look a lot stronger and more deliberate in your body movement. You're killing it.
When I walked into the gym for the first time, it was like this immediate like recognition of experience where it's like, hey, like you're black and you climb like I do. And also, I had never seen so many things running out of the gym. Whether it's like a food drive or resources for the community.
The thing is, the campus of Memphis Rox has unlimited potential. The rock climbing gym was just the beginning, but the bigger picture is a lot of help for this neighborhood.
So have you even been in here? It is all pay what you can, but anybody from the community can come in here and grab whatever essential item that they need. Mm-hmm.
We ask that people pay it forward here with our clothes closet, with our juice bar, which is in the middle of a food desert, because Jamba Juice ain't around here. You can get fried chicken, you know what I mean, a greasy burger, and that'd be about it.
You know, originally we were talking about just doing like a pay what you can grocery store, and even a teaching kitchen. And it's not just training people how to cook, right? It's how to manage a restaurant, how to manage a grocery store. We've done a lot of work, but we have a lot more. I mean, just with job training and free lunch program and the outdoor program. We've already seen what it does for teenagers getting outside for the first time and even climbing, hiking.
People in urban environments around the country deserve to go outside because like it's a reset.
What made me start caring about rock climbing, though, is that I had to firsthand experience, like, this is what Mother Nature gifted us.
Voluntarily going in the woods as a black man is a different type of experience, you know what I'm saying?
Like, I walked to my grandma's house. Like, I'll cut through the Crip neighborhood, but shit.
White people be terrified to walk through a Crip neighborhood, but these motherfuckers will hike through bear country.
Mother Nature is the toughest hood I've ever had to walk through.
After you get right there, you catch this crump right here.
Yep.
And then you put your heel where your right hand is. Nice.
This could be your project for today.
So last time at Horse Fins, I didn't get to see Aiden climb. I just heard about the stuff he did. This kid, first time here, man, he flashed sand rock. And it's like, what?
Nice, Aiden. Good match.
Aiden's, you know, socially awkward at times, but who, hell, I was too. The way that it translates into climbing is his superpower. It's not something that hinders him.
Switch.
Yeah, I would almost like walk my hands here, money, like this. So inside. Yeah, now you're on that good part of the hold and you're ready to fire.
So many times, like, if it's not a huge, crazy athletic achievement, then like we're overlooking it.
Yeah, dude. Right foot over.
We should be focusing on the joy and normal everyday climbers receive. It doesn't have to be about them sending a 555. E.
So you, like, if you give it 10, like set a 10 minute timer, look at your phone or something and try it again in 5 or 10 minutes, you'll feel way stronger than you do right now.
Okay.
You're not done for the night. You're done for the minute.
Yeah. Kind of weak. Boom. Okay. But I got the beta though.
Yeah, dude. Boom. Come back and send this thing.
It's a good one of Armani.
What kind of face is he making?
Oh, he got his tongue out.
We missed you on the trip. But what you working on?
Project it is paint.
Oh, no, that's the start? Jesus Christ.
Yeah, that's the start right there. Just like this. You're perfectly fit, bro.
When I photograph people in the gym, I want to photograph them in a way that showcases them as a human and not just a climber. Climbing is just one aspect of anything that we do. So Q is an interesting character. Like, he has a lot of spirit, and like music's a whole nother creative avenue that we don't get to see at work particularly. What y'all working on today? Is it something new, or is it gonna be like y'all expanding on something y'all already been working on?
We're gonna be expanding on something we was working on, like finishing.
Correcting a little bit. It's really cool to be able to truly see how he approached lyricism. It's, you know, just another aspect of him.
The shorty, she bad, ain't trying to front. Let's finish the wood, blessed off from this joint. Yes, I see stars, I see the moon. We galaxy bloom, we fly in the room. We surfing this ocean, reflect from the stars. If really just want it, we blasting the fog. We going on universal, not a saw. If you really just hate it, understand my flaw. I don't want no quarrel, I'm not biting my thumb.
Rock climbing is humbling experience. Mankind bends the will of everything around it to what we want it to do. And I think every human needs that understanding of, like, you know, the circle of influence of things you can impact and the things that you can't do anything about. Everybody told our founder, no. Why would you build a rock climbing gym in the hood? Don't you know black people don't climb? Now it's here and we've seen what it's done and what it's capable of. If you want to go climb El Cap, you need to climb Soulsville, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, okay.
And if you do want to know how to diversify, come to Memphis Rox. Come see our staff. See how we employ the community. See how we feed the community. See how we serve the community. See how we climb within the community. We're a pillar in our community, and we're not for profit, we're for people.
We surfing this ocean, reflect from the stars. If really just want it, we blasting the fog. We going to universal, not a saw. If you really just hate it, understand my flaw. I don't want no quarrel, I'm not biting my thumb. I just want your love, no hunger from one. I just learn all up in my room. Sitting in meditation without a broom. Yeah, my broom in my mind, my hunger, my line. You early wanted, got some shrooms. Pull up, got some room.